To God be the glory, great things he has done. We want to specially welcome you to the 11th day of the 50 days fasting and prayers of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. We want to say thanks to the Almighty God for answers to our prayers in the past. We believe that our lives are changing. We believe that spiritually we are being revived. We are being strengthened from the inner man. And we know that our lives will never remain the same for good in the name of Jesus. If this is your first time on this platform, please, I want you to subscribe to this channel and then hit the bell button so that whenever the prayer points for other days are dropped here, you can get notified of it and you can participate in the prayers. God bless you. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of life and we thank you for the power of your spirit that is at work in us, that has helped us and sustained us in the past 10 days of this fasting and prayer. Be glorified in Jesus' name. Today, once again, we are before you to present ourselves, to present our needs, to present our petitions. Father, please answer us in your name, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Welcome one more time. My name is Olumide Odesanya, and today is Tuesday, the 21st of January, 2020, the day 11 of the 50 days fasting and prayers. And the prayer focus today is on prayer for spirit of obedience. Prayer for the spirit of obedience. And our text that we'll be reading is found in Jeremiah chapter 10 verse 24. Jeremiah chapter 10 verse 24. And it says, O Lord, correct me, but with judgment, not in thine anger, lest thou bring me to nothing. O Lord, correct me, but not in thy anger, so that you do not bring me to nothing. And we pray that God will help us to yield to his correction, to yield to his voice, to yield to his word, so that we will not be destroyed in the name of Jesus. So our first prayer point talks about we praising and worshiping God for who he is. So let's just go ahead and worship God for who he is. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place for argument. You are God all by yourself. Jesus, you are God from beginning to the end. There's no place for argument. You are God all by yourself. Oh, glory, glory, glory to the Lord. Oh, glory, glory, glory to the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed be the name of the Lord of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed be the name of the Lord. May the Lord accept our worship and praise in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Second prayer point says, let us thank God for his marvelous work on the earth. Let us go ahead and thank God for his marvelous works on the earth. Our God doeth wonders in heaven. He doeth great things upon the earth. We can feel his presence in all languages, all tribes, across all nations of the world. He rules and reigns in the affairs of men. Lord, we thank you for giving rain to us in due season. Thank you, Lord, for making the land yield to us in due season. Thank you, Lord, for making the weather, the atmosphere conducive for our good and our viable existence. Lord, all the praise and glory to your name. For your wondrous works upon the face of the earth, Lord, we come to say thank you. Blessed, glory and honor, adoration be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we give thanks. Amen. Prayer point number three says, let us thank God for his mercy and goodness in our lives and families. Lord, we thank you for your mercies and goodness. For your word tells us in Romans chapter 9 that it is by the mercy of God that we have not consumed. It is not of him that willeth or him that runneth, but of God that showeth mercy. Lord, we are living today by your mercy. We are preserved by your mercy. We are kept by your mercy. And thank you, Lord, for the show of your goodness to us. Thank you for the breath of life within us. Thank you for the sanity of mind. Thank you for the health of our bodies. Lord, we can lift our hands. We can lift our legs. Lord, we say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for sanity. Thank you, Lord, for being in our right frame of mind. Lord, we say be glorified. Thank you for how good you've been to us individually and as represented families. Everyone watching from all over the world, Lord, we say thank you for how good you've been to us, for your abundant mercy, your enduring mercy, and for your unfailing goodness. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Amen. Let us thank God for his goodness and mercy in his church. Lord, we thank you for your word that tells us in Psalm 23 verse 6 that surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. And this is actually the closing prayer of the church. Thank you, Lord, for making goodness and mercy to abound and to abide in your church. Thank you, Lord, for the strength of your goodness and your mercy that has sustained your church, that had kept your church together despite all attacks, all challenges, left, right, and center from all over. Thank you, Lord, for making your grace, your goodness, and your mercy available to your church, preserving your church from the attacks of the enemy and the wicked one, and for keeping your church strong. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number 5. Let us thank God for the Bible, the written word of God, which is the manual for our soul. Lord, we say thank you for your word of life, which is able to convert our souls, your word of life that transforms from within to the without. Thank you, Lord, for giving us your word, the word of God, tried and tested, the word that can change the life of a man completely from worse to the best, that can change a man from being a sinner to becoming a saint, that can change a man from being a failure to becoming a success. Lord, we thank you for the power in your written word to the church. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Amen. Let us thank God for divine guidance and instructions for our well-being, which are contained in the Bible for us to obey. Thank you, Lord, for divine guidance and instructions for our well-being in your word. Your word tells us that you wish above all things that we prosper and be in health, even as our soul prospereth. Thank you, Lord, for prospering our souls through the power of your word to guide us into all truth, to instruct us in the path of righteousness. Lord, we say thank you for the power in your word. All scripture is given by the inspiration of God, profitable for doctrine, for instruction, for reproof, that the man of God may be thoroughly furnished. Thank you, Lord, for the impact of your word upon our lives. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Amen. Prayer point number 7, you will say, Father, be merciful unto us for all our acts of disobedience. Lord, we ask, O God, in your mercy, we come as a church, we come as a people, we come as individuals, we come as members of a family, we come as members of the body of Christ, and we ask for mercy, O God, in whatever way we have exhibited disobedience to your word, where we have allowed our flesh to lead us, where we have resisted your will for our lives. Father, we plead for mercy. You are rich in mercy. Let your mercy attend to every one of us. In any way, Lord, we have disobeyed your word, either knowingly or unknowingly. We plead for mercy today. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. We say, Father, please give us a willing heart to obey your command to go and win souls. In the name of Jesus, Father, we ask, O God, for a willing heart to do the will of God from the very heart, to be able to reach out to other souls, just as you have saved us, Lord, to take the burden for the kingdom, for the winning of souls, for the preaching of the gospel, by all means, at all times. Lord, we ask for the grace, O God, to have a willing heart to obey your command of going out, to obey the great commission of being soul winners, Lord, of being disciples of souls for your kingdom. So shall it be, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number 9, you will say, Father, teach us to number our days so that we may rightly apply our heart to wisdom. Lord, we ask, O God, according to your word in Psalm chapter 90, verse 12, that you will please teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Wisdom to obey you, wisdom to yield to you, wisdom to submit to you, wisdom to fellowship with you, wisdom to live as you will live on earth, wisdom to seek you on a daily basis, wisdom to yield to you. Father, we ask, O God, for wisdom as we number our days, as we increase in years, as we increase in years every single day. Help us, O God, to also increase in wisdom in our hearts, in wisdom to respond to you as our God. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number 10, you will say, Father, do not give us up or do not give up on us, but deal with us according to your mercy and compassion. Lord, please do not give up on us. Lord, do not mete out judgment against us for any disobedience, any act of disobedience, any act of not yielding to your will. Father, we ask, O God, that you do not give up on us. Let your mercy be much more, be greater than your judgment in the name of Jesus. Your enduring mercy that you show to the children of Israel. Lord Jesus, we receive that same mercy, O God. Do not give up on us. Be compassionate unto us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Prayer point number 11, you will say, Father, do not give up on us. Rather, you say, Father, direct our path to fulfill your counsel so that we can eat the good of this land, of this country, Nigeria. The word tells us in Isaiah chapter 1, verse 19, if ye be willing and obedient, you will eat the good of the land. Lord, we know that there is good in all nations of the world. It doesn't matter how negative things, it doesn't matter how terrible things are happening there. There are good things you have planted and deposited in all lands, all nations. Lord, we ask, O God, that in your mercy, you will direct us in the path, Lord, that we may fulfill your counsel, your purpose, so that we will enjoy the good in this land. Lord, I will enjoy the good in Nigeria. Everyone watching right now and praying this prayer, you will enjoy the good in your nation. In the name of Jesus, wherever the sole of your feet has been treading, I will tread in the name of Jesus. The good on that land will come to you. You will enjoy it. The land will be blessed for your sake. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. We say, Father, please speak to us in the language we can always understand, so that we can know exactly what you want us to do. Lord, our hearts are opened, our ears are opened. We ask, O God, you will speak to us in the language that we will easily understand and comprehend, in the name of Jesus, so that we will know exactly what you want us to do. Pray for yourself, dear brethren. Lord Jesus, grace to have an open heart, open ears, open eyes, Lord, to behold you, to be able to receive instructions in clear terms from you, to know what you want me to do, what you do not want me to do, how you want me to live, to glorify your name and to fulfill my destiny. Lord Jesus, we receive this grace in the name of Jesus to understand you in clear terms and clear languages that will transform our lives. In Jesus' unfailing name we have prayed. Amen. And finally, prayer point number 13, you will say, Father, guide our heart right to discern the voice of strangers and not to be obedient to them. Father, we ask, O God, you will guide our hearts, Lord, to discern the right voice, to discern your voice, to obey your voice and not to obey the voice of strangers. Strangers that may manifest in various dimensions as false prophets, as fake teachers, as merchandise of the gospel. Lord, whoever they may be, Lord, help us not to be able to listen to them. We ask, O God, that you will guide us with your right hand. Guide us with your word to know what to do, to know when to obey you at all times, to yield to you, that we will not listen to the voices of strangers in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. So shall it be. In Jesus' unfailing name, we have prayed. Amen. Father, we thank you for answers to our prayers. Thank you, Lord, for the new things you are beginning in our walk with you. Our lives are changing. We are getting better. We are revived and refreshed again, that the spirit of obedience has come upon us afresh. So shall it be. We go forth today and we prosper. We possess our possession in the land of the living to glorify God. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Amen. All right. Thank you for praying this prayer together with me. This channel basically is for spiritual enrichment. It's a platform where we share together on personal development, we share together on relationship and family issues, we share together on inspirational songs from the Bible and also prayers as we are doing right now. So please, you can like this video, share it with your friends, and you will do well to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification button so that you get other videos of prayers, encouragement, development of self, and all other things on this platform as we drop them. God bless you. My name is Olumide Odesanya. See you tomorrow in Jesus' name. Amen.